everyone. This is my wife Pooja and I'm George. We pastor and oversee a couple of churches in Bangalore. And over the years, as we have been pioneering, planting and pastoring churches, we have been looking into the scriptures about how the Lord would want this ministry to go forward and what the scripture says about teaching the children of the ways of God. My wife has been a significant contributor to my understanding of this facet of ministry. I have learned over the years that that the church has a significant role to play in this aspect of church life. And we initially started off this ministry where we took it to a plane where we wanted to see that the children would enjoy coming to this place and that they could be open and free to express themselves and in the process be open to receive what we are going to speak to them. So we created curriculums ourselves and our team members. Packed that with different activities like songs and dance and activities that would educate them about the different aspects that we want them to learn from the scriptures. That was a nice journey. We built curriculum, we trained up people. But recently again, the Lord has been speaking to us about how we should take this forward. And my wife has been especially hearing from the Lord in this area. And why don't you tell us about what you feel about?
So my burden regarding children would be that what I have understood is that children from very young ages, we think that they cannot understand the gospel, but the Bible says that Jesus says, don't stop the children from coming to me. So even if they are very young, the Bible says that out of the mouth of babes, he brings forth praise. And so we cannot say that a particular child is too young to know the Lord or to understand or enjoy God's grace or different giftings or everything that is possible for any adult, a child should be able to enjoy. And I believe that the church should be able to minister to children and bring forth those giftings and those spiritual understandings in the child, regardless of how young they are. And if your church is big enough and has sufficient manpower and resources that they can minister to smaller children, then you can have children from the age of 2, 3 up until the age of maybe 12, 15. You have a ministry that you can run towards children where they can understand the Bible. They are the Bible says they are sinners. Until they know Christ, they are sinners, and they only the gospel can be bring them to salvation. Yes, they are covered with grace because the fact that they are born into our families and our faith, but still they have to come to a personal relationship, personal understanding of who Jesus is, and it is the job of the church to bring them to that sort of an understanding, and that would be the role of the junior church. And sometimes I feel that as a Sunday school, what we normally do is we want the children to learn some things like, okay, just like they do their academics, they have to learn some lessons and they have to learn question answers and they have to, yes, all of that is very important, but much more important than all of the theory is that they begin to have a personal understanding and a personal walk with the Lord. And that, unfortunately for children, it only comes when they see people around them, that is the role models, that is people in church. And in when you say people in church, the first and foremost it comes is their own family, which is their own father and mother. So it is very, very important. It is so important, the way the father and mother, the family life is very, very important to these children. If we have a Sunday school that is teaching children for 45 minutes or 1 hour or 2 hours in a a week, and throughout the week the family is in a different way. That means the father and mother are not having a good relationship, or what they are practicing, what they are preaching, or what they are speaking is not what is being practiced at home. Then the children, they learn that this, what they are learning, is only theory and it cannot be put into practice, and this is a big crisis. And what happens is that even the chance, the only possibility that they could have come to faith, to know Jesus, to know the truth and to walk in the truth with the living God, that is being sabotaged, that is being destroyed. So it is so important for the family to understand the big responsibility that they have, that maybe 6 days in a week, more than that, like out of the number of hours in a week, 66 hours in a week, they are with their parents, and that is the bigger influence. And so parents need to take this into consideration and begin to see that their walk is so crucial to how their family, their children come to faith. And regarding the Sunday school ministry and the children's club, yes, we are, even it, the, I believe a church that values its children is a growing church. And so as a church, we have to value the children and have a thriving children's ministry. But we have to, as a children's ministers, we have to teach parents, we have to bring awareness to families. What a great responsibility is upon the family when you talk about children. So if you say, okay, my job as a parent is to bring my child to church, and then the Sunday school teacher is supposed to teach, I believe that is a big lie. And we have to understand that, and we have to be very careful about that. The Sunday school, I think today, in today's need, I feel what we are, I'm beginning to feel, is the Sunday school has, yes, it has a role to teach the children, but much more today, in today's time, the role or the need of the hour is for the Sunday school team, ministry team, to be equipped to prepare and equip parents to begin to live that kind of life before their children and with one another at home, and be equipped to begin to minister to their own children, so that, because that is a louder and much more effective voice than the 2 hours that children get in the junior church or in the children's club that they are. But definitely, yes, children have a space and a voice in the church. There has to be ministry that focuses on them, like as a people group. They are a people group, and this people group, maybe we need extra training. Not everybody knows how to work with children. You cannot work with children the way you work with adults. You have to work in a different kind of way. If you are a parent, you know how your child understands. If you do not know how your child understands, then there is a problem. Your child has been given to you because you are the one who needs to be ministering to that child. It's not only food, water and shelter, but even the faith that you have received has to be shared to that child in the way that child understands and that child can receive. The child is watching the father and mother much more than the child is watching anybody else, and so that is so important. And so I think our churches and the junior church ministry has to move in that direction of bringing about this focus, opening the eyes of the families to see what a great voice and what a great influence the family is into the life of that child. But yes, you need to have a team, and that team, a team that is well equipped to handling children and their specific needs. I believe the children of today is different. It is a evolving crowd, and we have to evolve along with that to be able to understand what are the needs of today's children. Just by just teaching some theory, they are not going to be impacted. We have to be able to take the stories in the Bible and in a living faith, demonstrating a living faith to them that they can apply in their day-to-day situations that they are facing, with peer pressure or the other so many things that are coming against them in today's world is not like yesterday's world. It We have a very new kind of lifestyle with a lot of media and a lot of electronic gadgets and things like even working with parents, or parenting is something that Children's Ministry needs to do, equipping parents and also equipping themselves to work with the children of today. I think there is a whole new arena that we as ministers need to be thinking and moving so that, you know, we can really reach out to this people group, you know, the children of today.
I agree with you. It is that my eyes are also opening to this. The church is a family of families, and somewhere along the way we have understood, or the families rather have understood, that the spiritual growth and the spiritual understanding, the spiritual well-being of the child is something that the church should take care of. And because, you know, our society being the heart of outsourcing business, somewhere we have all outsourced the whole training of our children in the ways of God to the church, and expects the church to. I have heard so many parents talk about saying that, I don't see a good junior church here. I don't see a good Sunday school. How will my child grow? How will my child know the Lord? But, you know, in the year from the beginning of this year, as a church, we are all going through from Genesis all the way to Revelation till December. And in the beginning, we are seeing, especially in Exodus and towards the end of Genesis, we see God speaking about families and the need for fathers and mothers to teach their children. I think all through the scriptures, the onus of educating and teaching and training the children in the ways of God is primarily resting upon the father and the mother. So we are very clear. I mean, we are slowly seeing this much more clearer right now, that the church's responsibility, as my wife always says, is to facilitate, is to educate the parents, and help the parents interact closer with the children, help the parents to understand the scripture in a way the child can understand, and then speak to the children about it in the context of the children. I understand. I'm an unpad here. I'm an uneducated fellow in this area. My wife has been as a good trainer to me to learn this aspect. And over the years, I have developed an excellent relationship with my children, with the ability to speak to them spiritual things and speak about the scriptures. My eldest daughter has received the Lord, and her personal life and walk with the Lord, her reading of scriptures, her discussion with us has been one of the most enriching experiences for me. And my wife has been a key player in that area, because she thinks children, she thinks children's ministry. So the whole possibility of the church being a facilitator rather than being the primary teacher to the child is an avenue and an arena that we are exploring. And we are thinking that our tomorrow's children's club or junior church should be a place where the parents come in, the children come in, and the children's club or the junior church or the Sunday school would actually facilitate a program where the parents and the children would interact in a healthy setting. And that would actually spark off a wonderful relationship, spark off an opportunity for the father and mother to invest their life, invest their faith and understanding of the scriptures into their children. What do you think?
So I would say there needs to be a totally like a paradigm shift in the way that we even run our own families. Like a lot of work needs to be done even in our understanding of marriage, even in our understanding. So the whole thing has to be, because culture, unfortunately, today is saying a particular thing. Culture says that, okay, right now what we need is, we need a house, after that we need a car, we need this, we need that. What I need to be giving my child is, you know, maybe I need to go foreign vacation, tour. But we are forgetting that the most important thing, some of those most important things, children cannot live without, that they thrive on, is a parent's time and attention, affection. These you cannot do without it. it doesn't go away with culture. So helping parents to understand their children and the need of their needs of their children, I think it is so important. Today's child, I think, is a very, I don't know if I should use the word neglected, abandoned child. Because today what we see today, 10 hours of a child or 10 to 11 hours of a child goes in just school academics. But what about the time with the parent? Tuition, this, that. Even at home, what is the father and mother doing? You ate, you had bath, you did your homework, did you do this, did you do that? So where is the time for recreation? Where is the time for all of that sharing, all of that affection, all of that playing? Children learn with playing. All of that is not there anymore. And then we go and say that, okay, this is the Bible says this, Joshua did that, Moses did this. How? The children don't even want to accept it. So we have a generation, it's like, you know, the Bible says, and then they came up a generation that did not know the Lord. And regardless of how great is our faith, you know, if that is not caught by our children, not that faith, I don't know if it can be taught, it has to be caught. They see, and what they see is what they believe, rather than what we are speaking, it has to match. So I feel a lot of work has to be done into the parenting. So if you have a Sunday school group, the Sunday school group has to be ministering, has to be trained and equipped to handle children in all of their aspects. They should know the Bible, those ministers should know the Bible very well. They should know children very well. They should know today's children and their needs very well. They should know parenting, and they should have sufficient training, or at least get sufficient, you know, arrange for those kind of teaching sessions where parents are equipped, because all of that goes into building up the children of tomorrow. So it is not that 2 hours, it is just not the 2 hours of just, you know, making sure that they stay out of the main service so that the parents can attend the service. Or it is not about they learn some theory and they pass the quiz, or they pass the Sunday school exam, or they learned a lot of songs. Yes, I totally enjoy songs and dance, and everything should be there for children, games. That is the way children learn. But we also need to see how a child learns. We need to understand the psychology, the needs of today's child, and work, it's like, what would Jesus do today? Where would his heart be? His heart, if you are concerned and burdened about the children, his heart is with the children. What about the children is Jesus' heart upon? Is it that they should know all of those stories? Is it that they should get a good mark in all of those things? And no, I don't think so. I think their life has to be impacted. And sometimes even we parents don't know, how do we impact our children's lives? When I'm struggling with my teenager, how do I impact my, how do I handle? See, these are the things I feel today's junior church or Sunday school has to be equipped, or get these kind of learning sessions in place. This is the kind of ministry that the church needs to have. It has to, we are an evolving ministry, we are an evolving crowd, an evolving generation, and we have to think along those lines.
To summarize the whole thing, I think what we're trying to say is that the way we've been doing junior church, where we have facilitators or teachers who come in, and for 2 hours in a week, we give the children a fantastic experience, an opportunity to understand the Lord in a fun way and His ways. We are saying we need that, but we need to bring into this setting the parents of the children, and the parents actively participate in the whole process of that of teaching and learning that happens in the 2 hours. And the parent then continues. It basically sparks the parent, and the parent then carries the spark all through the week, daily. There could be assignments of working together in the week, and the parent works, the mother works separately, the father works with the father, the mother works together with the child. And at the climax of it would be again the coming week's time together in the children's club, where the children look forward to fellowship with each other, the children together, and along with the parents. And I think it also will become a common burden among the parents to pray for the children. We are also looking at another dimension of, you know, the kind of understanding we have in the fellowship in the church and the way we understand God. I think the world outside, the community children outside, has the right to know this. They deserve to know this. And we have seen and we have taken this to the community. The community has been coming in. And we have seen over the years, the children from the community, more interested, excited parents coming in, leaving the children, sometimes being there. And we are now, here is another opportunity where we can bring the children, the parents of the community, children into the setting where the community parents actually hear and know the Lord. And that would be a fantastic experience of reaching out with the truth of the gospel, knowing the Lord who made the heavens and the earth, and in a wonderful, simple, humble setting where children are learning.
The fun part of that is that children are very very spontaneous and very innocent and very they are very natural. So when you have a child who is from outside who just come in and they have never seen any of what we are doing and all of the structure and everything, they have not seen all of this fun and jumping and songs and dance and you know, all the story time, and they have, and they really enjoy, and some of the parents come and say like, wow, this is so nice what you are doing, and they are really touched by the love. And some of the children come, after many years they come and say, you remember me, auntie, I used to come for your VBS a long time ago, and it feels so nice to see today they are in college. And but some of them have very sad stories, but at least they, you know that they can reach out to you. It feels so good, and you know, it's such a very nice feeling. So I think there's a lot that the children's ministry can also do to the community. We can build a lot of people, a lot of you know, emotional building up that we can do, moral building up that we can do. We can be a support to the children. Today's children, again, we need to understand what is the need that they have, and we can be equipped, so we can get trained and be equipped. It's very important to be trained and be equipped to be able to reach out. So, you know, we met some, what was that magazine that we met? There was a magazine once a month that they do something into the community. It's such nice materials that you get that they have, which are very low Indian, which can be easily adaptable to a person from a vernacular background, and you know, stories on what to do when you're, for example, what do you do when your parent passes away, when you, how do you handle that grief? So there are lessons that we can teach which build up people, you know, and so what do you do when you face danger? What do you do? How do you handle all those things? Today's children don't know, and nobody is teaching them. So why not the church can be a support. So children's ministry can, you know, it has so many options of reaching out to these people that Jesus loves so much, you know, the children that of this of our communities.
So to close, my wife and me would like to really appreciate all of those who have been serving in the church, in the children's ministry. Over the years, over the last 8 to 9 years, we have had some of the most amazing people who have served sacrificially, served so passionately. So we here, my wife and me, would like to appreciate, thank, and bless those who have heart for children, whether you are curriculum maker, whether you are you know, helping in the pantry, putting up the food, or you are taking the child to the restroom, or you are up there front jumping and dancing, or you are trying to communicate the gospel, you are struggling through it, maybe you are in the process of disciplining the child, in whatever phase it's in, whatever ways that you contributed, we want to say there is a reward waiting for you in heaven. God bless you.